Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we'll learn how to assign the basic dimension, that is quick dimension, linear dimension, radius dimension, diameter dimension, angular dimension. So let's see. Now we'll see how to assign the basic dimension. So let's go in AutoCAD. Just click on the new tab. So before assigning any dimension, we have to first set the units. So we'll just go in the units, because we need to know whatever precision we are taking for the units. So mostly we take 0.00. We will be working in decimal. You can either take inches or mm. So I will just take mm for my working. Just click OK. According to the same precision, we have to apply in the dimensional manager. So for that, just enter D. Click on the modify. We'll just go in the primary units. Here also we'll set the same precision. It is 0.00. Just click OK. Click on the set current. Just click close. Now we'll see how to assign the dimensions. So I'll just create some sketch. I'll just create one rectangle, one circle, the circle for giving the diameter dimension. So we'll just create one arc. Now here I have created the sketch for the dimension. Now let's see how to give the dimension. First I will show you a simple method, that is using the shortcuts. So for using the shortcut, we have to enter DIM. So basically this DIM initial will be same for all the dimension. So just click enter. See, here there are various options, that is angular, baseline, continuum and all. So I will just give the normal dimension first. So for that, just click the start point and give the end point and just press anywhere out. Here basically the dimension has been shown, but it is smaller. So we'll just go in the dimension style manager again. For that, press D, enter. We'll just go in modify. Here we'll go in the text and we'll increase the text height. Suppose I'm taking 6 as my text height. And according to that, I will just increase the arrow size to say 4. Click OK. Click on the set current. Click on close. Now also our dimension is not visible, so I will again go in the manager. We will take the text head as 15. According to that, the arrow size will take as 12. Click on set current. Click on close. Now basically our dimension is somewhat visible. So like this we can assign the simple dimension. Now we'll just go here to get all the dimension. First is quick dimension. So here basically you have to just click on the line on which you have to get the dimension. Suppose I want dimension of this line, just select this line, press enter and just drag outward and just click OK. Now you can see the dimension has been shown. So like this you can use the quick dimension. Next is linear dimension. For that we have to just enter point to point. It will show me the dimension. And the shortcut for this is DIM and L. So you can get the dimension linear shortcut. Just press enter. So like that you can just use the dimension for any line, that is horizontal or vertical. And suppose if the line is inclined like this at some angle, so for that you have to use the align dimension. Okay. Or just click on the align dimension point to point. Okay. You can get the align dimension for any line, and the shortcut for this will be DIM A L. So you will get dimension aligned. So like this, you can use either from here or you can just use the shortcuts. Now we will see how to give the radius. So for that, press DIMRA. So you will get the shortcut for dimension radius. So it is asking for select an arc or circle. So I will just select the circle here. See, like this, we can give the radius. Suppose I want to give the diameter, then again the initial will be same, that is DIM. After that, we have to just enter the initial of the dimension which we have to take. Suppose I want to take the diameter, so I will just enter DI. So it will show me the diameter. Just select the circle. Now it is showing me the diameter symbol and the diameter of the given circle. You can also go here and select the radius or diameter whichever you want. Now next we will see how to get the arc length. So just go here, or you can select the arc length from here. You can just, or you can simply enter the shortcut in the command manager. Select the arc. Okay. With this arc length symbol, it will be showing me the arc length of the given arc. Next, we will see how to get the angular dimension. For that, I will just click on the angular. So, select the first line and select the second line between which you want the angle. Okay. So like this, you can get the angle between any line. The shortcut for this will be DIMAN. And get the angular. Suppose I want the angle between these two lines, so I'll just select these two lines one by one. We'll be getting the angle. Next we'll see the ordinate. So basically ordinate will be showing me xy coordinate of any point which I have selected. Suppose I want x and y coordinate of this point, so I'll just click on this point. See, it is showing me first the x coordinate, and again go in the ordinate. Then click on this point and just drag here. That is showing me this as my x coordinate from this origin, and this will be of my y coordinate. Like this, we can get the coordinate. I will show once again. Just go here, click on the ordinate. Suppose we want ordinate point of this, so just click on this point. This will be my one coordinate, and again we'll just go in the ordinate. And this will be my other coordinate. So basically, this is my x coordinate and this is my y coordinate from this origin point. So like this, we can assign the dimension. And if you want to still increase the text height, you can again go in the dimension style manager, click on modify. I'll just increase the height to say 22, click OK, click on the set current, click close. Like this, you can add and change the dimension according to your need. Thank you friends for watching this video.